COVID. California to keep mask requirements for vaccinated till June 15th. It looks like Prince Harry is assimilating just fine into the American life of a liberal celebrity. He's becoming a regular target of top US conservatives, who have roasted him for complaining about wanting privacy and about the way he and his wife, Meghan Markle, both millionaires, were cut off financially by the royal family when they moved to the United States. But Harry really set himself up for the Fox News, Breitbart, Daily Caller outrage machine when he called the First Amendment bonkers in a recent interview. The outrage swept across Twitter Sunday and Monday, just as the official trailer for Harry and Oprah Winfrey's mental health TV series, The Me You Can't See, was released. Harry's mental health advocacy was the topic of his Armchair Expert podcast interview with Dax Shepard last week. The First Amendment came up when Harry was discussing the paparazzi feeding frenzy he and Meghan experienced when they stayed at Tyler Perry's Beverly Hills mansion after first arriving in the United States. I don't want to start sort of going down the First Amendment route because that's a huge subject and one in which I don't understand because I've only been here a short period of time, the grandson of Queen Elizabeth II said. But, you can find a loophole in anything, Harry continued. And you can capitalize or exploit what's not said rather than uphold what is said. I've got so much I want to say about the First Amendment as I sort of understand it, but it is bonkers, Harry added. While Harry's podcast interview was last week, his First Amendment quip began generating a huge wave of online criticism from top US politicians and conservative pundits over the weekend. They adopted the mantle of patriotism and accused the prince of being ignorant. They also told the member of a 1,000-year-old monarchy to go back to the United Kingdom if he has a problem with one of the foundational principles of American democracy. Nice that he can say that, tweeted Senator Ted Cruz, R. Texas. Well, I just doubled the size of my Independence Day party, added Representative Dan Crenshaw, R. Texas on Twitter. Better to remain silent and be thought a fool than to speak and remove all doubt. Lincoln or Twain or someone smarter than Prince Harry, tweeted former Fox News host Megyn Kelly. Current Fox News host Laura Ingraham added, don't let the doorknob hit you, Windsor. Political commentator and conspiracy theorist Dinesh D'Souza also said, I wonder if he also thinks the Fourth Amendment is bollocks, and the 14th Amendment is pish posh. Harry's usual critics in the UK had already weighed in on his First Amendment comments. They also had spent the past few days fuming at Harry for being disloyal to his father, Prince Charles, and to the Queen because he criticized the cycle of dysfunctional royal parenting.